Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us for Living Local, your lifestyle show for all things Charleston and beyond. I'm Ashley Meservey.
It's Medical Monday at East Cooper Medical Center, and today we're sitting down with a Lowcountry orthopedic surgeon to learn how he uses the latest technology along with traditional practices to treat those suffering from common knee, hip, and joint problems.
Medical Monday, sponsored by East Cooper Medical Center.
Joining us today, we have Dr. Schutte. He's here to talk to us about Mako technology, something that you know a ton about. First, let's talk about what is that?
Mako technology is a computer-navigated, somewhat robotic. The robot isn't doing the surgery, but it's a handheld surgery where you can set the parameters of how you want to put a joint replacement or resurfacing in and fine-tune it to within half a degree or half a millimeter. And you can make adjustments during the case so that you create the optimal size, shape, position of the joint replacement, which allows people to be back at work quicker and we believe is going to help make the implants last a much longer time. It's a little bit like having a tire that you can absolutely balance. You know, you could look at it by sight and get a sense or feel, but if you can calibrate it with some type of a GPS system so that you know that it's exact within a half a degree, that tire is going to last much longer on your car. And it's the same thing with the joint replacement.
And this is something that East Cooper is really passionate about, you know, and I think a lot of times when you hear about technology, you think that it's something like cutting edge. This has evolved over years because this isn't something super brand new, correct?
Well, it's really evolved over the last decade. Mm-hmm. When I started at East Cooper approximately 7 or 8 years ago, that was an important part of our mission and our program along with the hospital was to create a state-of-the-art joint replacement mm-hmm. program. And part of that was having the highest quality, the highest standard of implants available, the longest lasting implants, but also having the tools, the Mako technology, the RadLink, which is another intraoperative computer guided system that allows us to determine exactly how the implant is positioned in terms of its relationship to the bone, and again, giving a higher performance and a longer lifespan.
And so talk about though how it's evolved as far as, you know, getting your hip replaced, and it's not what it used to be though, right?
It isn't, and if you go back generations, and South Carolina actually has one of the longest histories in hip and knee replacement. Going back to the 60s, some of the earliest hips were developed through some of the pioneers in South Carolina, but it used to be a procedure where people were in the hospital for 4 or 5 days. You know, you had limited hip precautions for 6 to 8 weeks and didn't start therapy for a while. Now it's a procedure that almost entirely is done with a spinal or regional anesthesia. Takes generally less than an hour. Most people are up walking that day. People have the choice to go home that day or the next day. And we almost always have no precautions afterwards. People can put as much weight as they want to. Mm-hmm. And I'd say for our average patient, they're driving within a couple weeks. People that own their own business can go back to some type of part-time activity. Our concern has gone from getting people to do enough to getting people not to do too much early on so that they allow still things to heal. It takes about 6 weeks for the bone to grow into the implant.
And it's different than other surgeries too, because you stress a lot about preparation before the surgery, correct?
Right. It's a little bit like running a race. The fitter you are before the surgery, mm-hmm. the fitter you are after. I like to tell people that it's a little bit like a car. The joint replacement is like the wheel or the tire, and if it's worn down, that's like you're riding on the rim or you mm-hmm. have no tread. So you replace the tire and the wheel, but if you let the motor go, it doesn't matter how good the wheel or the tire
exactly.
is. And that brings us to the discussion of when should I get it done? So we talk to people about, you know, you should get it done before you get too weak. We mm-hmm. see people that have knee arthritis, for example, and they've had it for months and years. They're favoring that leg, and so they find
it's causing all kinds of other problems, right?
Well, you can see even with their clothes on that muscle is shrunk and that leg is a lot smaller than the opposite leg, mm-hmm. which they've been using for support. And at some point, if you let that go long enough, you cannot rebuild that muscle mm-hmm. to the previous state, no matter how hard you try. So we like to get people taken care of mm-hmm. While they still have a adequate muscle strength.
Because here at East Cooper, you want to, you know, treat the whole patient, and you don't want to just automatically say, all right, let's get you into surgery, right? You know.
Correct. We look at a number of factors. Smoking, for example, if somebody smokes, that increases the infection rate significantly, so we encourage people to stop that. We look at their dental work. You don't want to have major dental work a week after you have your hip or knee replacement, or because that puts bacteria into the system and can cause a problem. We look at diabetes and your A1Cs.
Sometimes losing weight and stuff too.
Losing weight, making sure you don't have any other significant medical issues. We like to get people as in as optimal health as possible before the surgery. Ideally, it's a surgery that should last a lifetime. We really think the implants and materials are good enough that it should be about a 40-year process. So,
and I think, you know, just getting in early and just getting the information, don't go on Google. Come to the experts and ask.
And find out if it's really even what you need. It may be that you have something simple that doesn't require a surgery that can be treated and get you back to full activity. The main thing is to allow people to be fully active. Mm-hmm. We kind of tell people, you know, it's like the thermostat in your house. If the house is cold, you can turn the heat up and sleep all night, or you can toss and turn and then get up in the middle of the night and turn the heat up. You're going to turn the heat up. You might as well do it sooner and enjoy the benefits longer.
Oh, I love that. All right, well, Dr. Schutte, thank you so much for having us. And for more information, head online to eastcoopermedctr.com.